All right, hello everyone, and today we're going to take a look at using logic in a compositional manner. I feel like logic is definitely one of the best DAWs for songwriters, composing, that sort of stuff, and we're going to take a look at it in that capacity today. Now, I'm a guitar player, so this might be a little guitar-centric, but you can follow a lot of the same concept if you're using software instruments as well, and we'll get into a little of software instruments and drummer. All right, so we got Logic open here. I don't have a project or anything open, so I'm going to hit Command N.
Choose default button. Choose a project. Create an empty project.
All right. So by default, it's going to ask you to create an empty project, but I'm going to jump to the top of this window and select one of the templates.
Table. New project. Row 1 of 7. Selected.
So just did VO Home to jump to the top of the window. I'm going to interact with this table.
In table. New project. Row 1 of 7. Selected. New project. Row 1 of 7.
And I'm going to go down to the template options.
Recent. Row 2. Starter grids. Row tutorials. Row 4 of 7. Demo projects. Row 5 of 7.
By the way, the demo project with Logic 10.5 is Oceanized by Billie Eilish. Check out that project when you get a chance.
Project templates, row 6 of 7.
All right, project templates. I'm going to do VOJ to jump into a template.
Image, hip hop, collection 1 item selected. Image, hip hop.
And these are some of the templates they have for you already ready to go.
Image, electronic. Image, songwriter. Image, orchestral. Image, multi-track.
So you kind of get an idea what these different templates are. Now I'm going to go to songwriter.
Orchestral, image, songwriter. Auto collection 1 item selected.
Stop
image,
interacting
songwriter.
With that.
An ideal writing studio with drums, bass, and premium amps together with vocal tracks.
All right, so that kind of gives you an idea of what the songwriter option is.
Details, expanded, disclosure triangle.
Now, this details group let you set your tempo, make sure you got your right audio interface and all that stuff selected before you create the project. So I'm going to interact with this details area and check on some of that stuff.
Details, group.
Interact with this.
In details, 96, segment 0, slider.
So I want to change this tempo, by the way.
Tap tempo button.
There's a tap tempo button here that we can use, so if I just VO space on this a few times.
Press tap tempo, press tap tempo, press tap tempo, press tap tempo button.
And go back to the tempo slider now via left arrow.
167, segment 0, slider.
That's what it thinks I want to set the tempo to based on what I tap. Now, I can just interact with this slider.
In slider, 150, 147, 130, 127.
Now you see 127. Now, if I want to go in single increments, because I was using via left and right arrow to move by increments of 10, I want to go in single increments, I can just do via shift left and right arrow. So I'm going to do via shift left arrow.
120, 123, 122, 121, 120.
Take that down to 120. Auto slider. All right, that's what I want.
Tap tempo button.
I'm going to continue navigating through this window.
C, Charlie, key signature, pop-up button.
You can set the key signature for your project.
Major, selected, radio button, minor, radio button, 2/4/4, scrubber groove.
You can set the time signature for your project.
Element 88, audio input, pop-up button.
You can set your audio interface here. The input is...
Element 88, audio output, pop-up button.
Set to the same thing as the output, as you can see.
Sample rate, 44.1, pop-up button.
Sample rate, I'm going to change this to 96K. I like to work at 96K.
Meant 48, 88.2, 96. Closing menu, 96, pop-up kilohertz. Frame rate.
And the rest of this is related to video, so I'm going to stop interacting
details,
here.
Group. Open an existing cancel, but choose default button.
And go to choose.
Now in untitled one, tracks, window, tracks, contents, group. Tracks, contents, group.
All right, so I'm going to stop interacting with this area.
Auto tracks, auto track.
Because I want to give you a brief tour of the Logic interface, so I'm going to press VO Home to jump to the top of this window.
Control bar, toolbar.
The very top of this window is the control bar. Control bar has your transport, things like changing your tempo, if you wanted to show or hide the library, the inspector, etc. You can do all that from the control groups. Now, those do also have their key commands, though you don't have to go in the control group to do that, but you will have to most likely go there if you want to change the tempo. All right.
Untitled one, tracks. Library, group.
Library. Library is where you can choose some patches, and patches are some presets that Logic Pro X has that are entire signal chains. So it could be a synth with some EQ and compression going to a reverb bus. It could be a guitar amp with some delays and a reverb bus, etc., etc. So it's a full signal chain ready to go, so you can get to creating right out of the box.
Inspector group.
The inspector is where you can manipulate items as it relates to the regions or tracks. So the region inspector, for example, you'll select the region you want to work with, and then you can go into the region inspector to, say, do a fade in, a fade out, a cross fade, etc. And you can select the track you want to work with and then go into the track inspector and, like, say, turn on flex time or something like that. All right.
Tracks group.
This is a tracks group. So now if I interact with the tracks group.
In tracks group. Tracks legend group. Tracks time ruler. Timeline. Tracks header group.
There's a tracks header.
Tracks contents group.
And track content. So track header is where I can go to select tracks. And if I interact with the track headers, I can mute solo, adjust the pan and volume and stuff like that for each track. Now, mute, solo, and input monitoring and record enabling all have keyboard commands, but if you want to adjust the volume or the pan, you will need to interact with the track header or do it from the channel script in the mixer. Track contents area is where you can actually get to the regions. The regions, if you're familiar with Pro Tools, they're called clips. If you're familiar with Reaper, they're called items. And that's where you can get to the regions. Now, you don't have to go into track content theory to edit. You can edit from the track headers, but there are some times you may want to go into a track contents area, and we'll get into that a little bit later. All right, so let's go to the track header and see what tracks this template came up with.
Tracks contents, group, tracks header, group, intro, track one, SoCal, group.
SoCal, that is our drummer track, and it does come up with a drummer region ready to go, an 8-bar drummer region, so if I hit space,
one,
you see there's a drummer region there, and we'll get into working with that in a little bit.
Track two, natural strong, group.
This is an acoustic guitar track. I'm going to delete this and just put a blank audio track in there and put an amp plugin on there so that I can record through an amp sim instead of using the acoustic guitar track that comes in this template.
Track three, track and vocal, group.
Track and vocal, that's obviously for, well, track and vocals. So you can record your vocal on that track. It's got some delays and reverbs and EQ and compression and de-essing loaded up on this channel strip ready to go. The de-esser and the delay are turned off, but there's some EQ and compression settings ready to go and some reverb settings ready to go as well.
Track 4 Hi-Fi DI, group.
This is a bass DI, so if you want to record some bass, this has got an instance of Bass Amp Designer loaded, ready to go.
Track 5 Steinway Grand Piano, group.
And Steinway Grand Piano is just a software instrument track that has Logic Steinway Grand Piano, and I have a MIDI controller over here, so if I do, just because I have that track selected, I can play the instrument on that track out of the box, ready to roll. All right, so I'm gonna jump back to the top of this window.
Track one, SoCal, group.
Or at least the track groups, and I'm gonna go to track two.
Track two, natural strong, group.
The acoustic guitar track. I'm gonna delete this, so Command Backspace.
Delete track. Track one, SoCal, group.
I'm gonna add a new audio track, Command Option A.
Track two, audio one, group.
I'm gonna turn on input monitoring. My guitar is plugged into input one. By default, Logic does use input one, so I should be able to grab my guitar and start playing. All right, so got my guitar here. Now I'm gonna go turn that drummer track down a little bit because it can be a little loud.
Track one, SoCal, group.
So it went back to SoCal, interact
with it. Track one, SoCal, zero pan, circular slider, plus 0.0 decibels, volume slider.
Interact with the volume slider.
Minus one, minus 6.0, minus 8.0, minus 10.0, minus 12.0 decibels, minus 10.0 decibels. One bar, one beat, one division, auto slider.
I should be able to hear my guitar over there.
Auto track one, SoCal, group. Track two, audio one, group.
And now in Logic, if you're only recording one track, once you have the track selected, you can just hit record and start recording to it. By default, Logic gives you a 1-bar count in. So if I hit record, it's going to count me for a bar and then start recording. Kind of messed up that second
one
half
one
there.
Division, one
so I'm going to split this at measure 5.
2 bars, 1, 3, 4, 5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
And I just moved the playhead to measure 5 with period. Period and comma moves you by bars in Logic. I'm going to do Command T.
Split regions, events, playhead position.
Split. And when you do a Command T to split in Logic, what is to the right of the playhead is selected. So from measure 5 on is selected.
5
That's
bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
Of. Hit delete.
5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
I'm going to give myself 2 measure count in instead of 1. So I'm going to VOM.
Menu bar, Apple. Logic Pro, file, edit, track, navigate, record.
Go to record.
Record, menu,
menu
count in, submenu.
Count in.
Count in, none. Check mark, 1 bar. 2 bars.
Select 2 bars.
2 bars, check.
All right, now my count in should be 2 bars instead of 1 bar. All right.
5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
Got that recorded. Now, if you do control, home, and end, it'll take you to the start and end of the selected region. Now, I just recorded from measure 5 on, so that's the region that's currently selected.
9 bars, 2 beat, 3 divisions, 141 ticks.
So, you see that ended somewhere after measure 9.
5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
Starts at measure 5. So, I'm going to jump to the end again.
9 bars, 2 beat, 3 divisions, 141 ticks.
The end of the selected region, and I'm going to hit comma to move to measure 9.
9 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
And I want to trim the ending of this recording. Now, in Logic, if you do command left bracket or command right bracket when you just have a region selected, it will set the start or end of a region to wherever the playhead is. So since I want this region to end at measure 9, I want to trim off everything after measure 9. I move the playhead to measure 9, hit command right bracket, And now this region now ends at measure 9. So if I do control home,
5 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick.
It starts at measure 5. Control end.
9 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick.
It ends at measure 9. All right. So we got that. Now if I hit return, I can go to the start of the project.
1 bar 1 beat 1 division
play
1
tick. Play this back. So, I want to repeat this region that goes from measure 5 to measure 9. So, I'm going to make sure that region is selected. So, we do control, home, and end.
9 bars 1 beat, 5 bars 1 beat, 1 division 1.
That region is still selected. So, I'm just going to hit command R to repeat it. So, now. So that region is repeated because, as you see, that drummer region is only for 8 bars, so you don't hear it for the second half of the repeated region. All right, so I'm going to drop another track in here. This time, I'm going to put an amp sim on it so I can get some distorted guitar tones, and we're going to record the next section. So I'm going to do Command-Option-A again.
Track 3, audio 4, group.
And this time, I'm going to jump into the mixer because I prefer to add effects from the mixer. So if I do Command-2, I'll open a mixer in a new window.
Now in, untitled 1, mixer, tracks, window, audio 4, partially hidden, channel strip group.
And you see it drops me right on the audio 4 channel strip. So if I interact with this.
In audio 4, partially hidden, channel strip group, 33 items, audio 4, name, text.
And that's the name. I can VO space on that and rename the track if I want. It's going to take me through the solo mute buttons and stuff like that. As I use the VO left arrow, it puts you all the way at the end of the channel strip.
Off, solo, switch.
So I'm using VO left to navigate.
Off, mute, switch, off, monitoring, mix, record, switch.
And that's the record enable.
0.0 decibels, volume fader,
that's
slider.
Your volume fader.
Off, peak button, off, 0.0, volume, yeah. 0.0, text, off, peak button.
That's your peak meter, so you can see the level of the track.
Off, 0.00, pan, circular slider, automation, group.
Pan, automation,
off, group button.
You can add the track to a
stereo output button, send button, send button, send button, audio plugin button.
Those are all the sends, and then these are the audio plugin slots where you can add effects.
Audio plugin, audio plugin, audio plugin, audio plugin, audio plugin, input one button.
I like to go all the way over to where it says input one, because that's also, by the way, input one, where you can choose your input. As you see, this track is set to input one. That's the input my guitar is plugged into on my audio interface.
Audio plugin button.
Audio plugin. So if I VO space on this.
Menu for the recent, dim, BX underscore Rock Rack 3, submenu.
I'm going to add BX Rock Rack, one of my favorite amp sim plugins, and it works very similar to the Logic plugins where it has presets in the Logic preset browser. I'm going to hit return to load this up.
BX underscore Rock Rack 3, check. Audio 4, dialog. Toolbar button, bypass, check, manual, pop-up button.
All right, so I'm going to turn on input monitoring for this track. So now if I hit left and right brackets, I can move for presets. And I'm going to turn the gate up on this plugin a little bit. So I'm going to navigate with VO right arrow.
View, link, unchecked, check button, collapse, button, collapse, disclosure triangle. Expanding button. Table, power, check,
interact
checkbox,
with this
selected.
Table. And by the way, you have to set the view to controls mode to see these settings. I'll show you where that is in a second.
Table, power, check, checkbox. Table, power,
so
check,
interact
checkbox.
With this selected table.
Table. Setting, a pop-up button, master out, minus one, recording chain, zero, amplifier type, noise gate, check, checkbox.
Noise gate.
Noise gate threshold, minus 98.4 decibel, minus 98.4 decibel, minus 98.4 decibel, slider.
Interact with that.
Minus 80, minus 70, minus 62.4 decibels. Minus 74.4 decibels. Minus 68.4 decibels.
That should be good. Alright, so that does what we need it to do. Stop interacting with this table. If I use VO left arrow,
button, extended, link, unchecked, checkbox, view, menu button.
You VO space on this view menu to change it to controls view. I have it set to come up in controls view by default. That's a setting you can change in preferences.
Audio 4. Close, right. Close button.
Close this.
Now in, untitled 1, mixer, tracks, window, audio plugin button.
You're going to do command accent to jump back to the main window. That's one of the advantages to open a mixer in its own window. You can just do command accent to jump back to the main window.
Now in, untitled 1, tracks, window, track 3, track 4, tracking vocal, group, track 3, audio 4, group.
So this is the track that we want to record on. So I'm going to do shift return.
Audio 4, content selected, edit text.
To rename this.
Selection replay, S-T-O-R-T-E-D, distorted, G-U-I-T-A-R.
Hit return. Now that track is named. I'm going to go back to track 2.
Track 2, audio 1, group.
And turn off input monitor on that track. So now just a distorted track is input monitored.
Track 3 distorted tuner, group.
All right, so back on track 3. And now I'm going to move this to measure
6 parts, 7, 8 parts, 9 parts, 10 parts, 11 parts, 12 parts, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 take.
Measure 12 and start recording from here. So before I record, I'm going to turn this track down a little bit because it is a little loud.
In track 3, distorted geometer, group, 8 items, horizontal splitter, 0 pan, circular split, plus 0.0 decibels.
Interact and find the volume fader. Stop interacting with the track header. Now I'm going to hit record and it's going to count me for 2 measures and then I can start recording. Got that recorded. So I'm gonna do Control N to jump to the end of that.
17 bar 2 beats, 4 divisions, 95 ticks.
See 17 bar 2 beats. I want that to end at 17, so I'm just gonna hit the comma.
17 bars 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
Takes me to measure 17. Command right bracket to trim that.
17 bars 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
There. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna duplicate this track. So
new track with duplicate settings.
Press Command D to duplicate.
Track 2 audio 1 group. Track 3 distorted geometer, group.
That's distorted guitar. I'm going to interact.
In track 3, 0 pan, circular slider.
Pan
to
circular,
10 of 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Auto circular slider. Auto track 3 distorted geometer. Track 4 distorted geometer, group.
And pan to
in track 4 distorted geometer, group. Horizontal slider. 0 pan, circular slider. Minus 10.0, 0 pan. In circular slider. 10 of 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Auto circular slider. Auto track 4 distorted geometer. Track 3 distorted geometer, group.
Turn off input monitoring on this one. Don't need it on track 3.
Track 4 distorted geometer, group.
I'm going to rename this distorted guitar too.
Distorted geometer. Content selected. Edit text. Selection ISTOR. D, distorted, G, U, I, T, A, R, guitar, 2.
All right. So, I hit shift return to rename it.
Track 3, distorted geometer. Track 4, distorted guitar, 2, group.
All right. So, now, you hear my guitar on the right side. If you hear my guitar on the left, you need to flip your headphones around. All right. So, I need to go back to measure 12.
16, 15, 14, 13, 12 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
And this is where I want to start recording from. So I'm going to hit record. It's going to count me for 2 bars, and then I can record. All right.
12 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
Got that recorded. Alright, so I can hit Option Return to jump to end of the project.
17 bars 3 beats 1 division 117 ticks.
And I'm going to move up to 17.
17 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick.
Trim that. So now it ends at 17, starts at 12.
12 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick. 17 bars 1 beat 1 division 1
ends
tick.
Ends at 17. Perfect. Alright, so earlier you saw me repeat a region. This time I'm going to copy and paste. So the part I played at the very beginning, I want that part to come up here again at measure 17. So I'm just going to go grab that copy and paste it at measure 17. So I'm going to go back to track 2, I believe it is.
Track 3, distorted geometer, group. Track 2, audio 1, group.
I'm going to rename this.
Audio 1, content selected, edit
clean
text.
Guitar.
Selection replay, L, E, N, clean, G, U, I, T, A, R.
All right, got it. And so now, when you navigate to a track, you select all the regions on the track. So if I do Control N.
13 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
See, that ends at 13.
1 bar, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
And starts at measure 1. So I just want that first region that goes from measure 1 to 5. So I'm going to tap the right arrow twice to select it, because you tap the left or right arrow once. You unselect all the regions, you tap the right arrow a second time, it will select the first region on the track. You tap the left arrow a second time, it will select the last region on the track. So I'm going to tap right twice, and
5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick. 1 bar, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
Now I have that selected, so do Command-C to copy.
Copy.
I'm going to go to Distorted Guitar.
Track 3, Distorted Guitar, group.
All right, I'm going to just do Control-N to jump to the end of this track, because all the regions are selected on this track, so if I do Control N, it'll put the playhead at the end of the selected region.
17 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick.
Right there. Measure 17. If I hit space.
17 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick.
You do Command V to paste.
Paste.
All right.
17 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick.
Now we're back at measure 17. I just hit space to play and stop real quickly, and it puts the playhead back at 17.
17 bars 1 beat 1.
See, we got that there. Now,
track 4, distorted guitar 2, group.
Go to distorted guitar 2. I'm just going to record a double for that part. And let me grab my guitar. All right. So now that I got my guitar, I am going to hit R to record a double. And it's going to count me in for 2 bars again. And then I can start recording my double. All right. Once again, I am going to need to trim this up a little bit. So I'm going to do Control N.
21 bars, 3 beats, 3 divisions, 141 ticks.
And hit the comma.
21 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
Right at measure 21. Hit Command right bracket. Region is trimmed. So now this goes from
17 bars, 1 beat, 1 division,
17
1 tick. 21 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
To 21. Perfect. Dead on. So go back to 17 with Control Home.
17 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
And
All right.
So we got that recorded. Now, I want to repeat this part. Logic has what's called locators, and locators allow you to work with entire sections of the project. You can use them to cycle, which is where you just loop an entire section of the project, but you can use them in the way I'm about to use them. So you saw me use Command R to repeat a region earlier. Now, I'm going to repeat everything between the locators because I want to double these two tracks. So I'm going to set a left locator or start locator right here at measure 17. So I'm going to do Command Option left bracket. That's the key command I have mapped to set a left locator at the playhead. And now I'm going to do Control N to jump to the end of the selected region.
21 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1
measure 21. Set my right locator there with Command Option right bracket. And now if I jump back to the start of this, so if I hit Command Option Home, it takes me to my left locator.
17 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
And Command Option End will take me to my right locator.
21 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
So I'm going to hit Command Option Home.
17 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick. 17 bars, 1
measure 17, Command Control R repeats between locators.
Logic Pro 10 has new window.
So now if I play from measure 17, all right, so you see that repeated. Now, the section that comes after that is the section that preceded it, the measures 13 through 17. So, once again, we're going to use locators to select those regions, copy them, and then paste them where we want. So, going to move to measures 13.
13 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
Just hit the comma a few times to go back. I'm going to do Command Option left bracket to set my left locator there.
14 bars, 15, 16 bars, 1, 17 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
Command Option right bracket to set my right locator there.
Track redistorted guitar group.
All right, so I just went up to the distorted guitar track. I'm going to do Shift down arrow to select the distorted guitar 2. It doesn't speak, but I just press Shift down arrow. Now, if you press Command Control T, it splits between locators and selects everything that you split. So I'm going to press Command Control T, and now those things between the locators are selected. I'm going to do Command C to copy. I'm going to hit Option Return to go to the end of the project.
25 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
Which is measure 25. Now if I paste.
Paste. 25 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
I just played and stopped to move the playhead back to 25.
25 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
And back up here to 24.
24 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
All right. So there you have it. We got that copied over. So a myriad of different ways you can use locators to just copy entire sections of songs. You can use Command C to copy a single region. You can use Command R to repeat a single region. You can repeat between locators. You can copy between the locators. And you can even remove stuff between the locators as well if you wanted to. So now that we got a basic sketch of the song here, I'm going to go back to a drummer track and let's take a look at the drummer because you notice there's no drums in this part of the song. So I'm going to hit return to go to the start of the project.
1 bar, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
And
track 2 clean guitar group, track 1 SoCal group, track 1 SoCal group.
Track 1 SoCal, that's the drummer track. And now, if you remember from what I said earlier, by default in this template, the drummer loads up with a 8 bar drummer region. And we can add more drummer regions to the track. The drummer is a region-based thing, so you can select regions, edit them, and that's how you make changes to the drummer for different parts of the song. So if I play this again, So what I want to do here now is I'm going to, first of all, split the drummer region at measure 5 because I want to affect measure 5 separately from what's at measure 1 through 5. I want to affect measure 5 through 9 differently. In fact, I want to extend measure 5 through 9 to go out to measure 13 where that section ends. So I'm going to do that in the track contents area. The drummer, this is one of the few things that is helpful to do in the track contents area. First of all, I'm going to split the region at measure 5. So I'm going to navigate to measure
2 parts, 3 parts, 1 beat, 4 parts, 1 beat, 1 division, 1
so two. Look at what happens when I split. I'm going to play from measure 4 right now.
4 parts, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
So now I'm going to go to measure 5.
4 parts, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
Split.
Split regions, events, play, head position.
I'm going to go back to measure 4.
4 parts, 1 beat, 1 division,
and
1 tick.
And here it'll lead into where I split. See, drummer put in a fill for us because I split right there. It just assumes you want to fill, and it puts a crash in on the downbeat.
So,
pretty cool. All right, so I'm going to jump into the track contents area.
Auto tracks header, group, tracks contents, group.
And interact with
this. In tracks contents, track 1 SoCal, track background.
And you can interact with the track background to see the region.
In track 1 SoCal, drummer region.
And that's the first drummer region.
Drummer region.
That's the second drummer region.
Add drummer region button.
And that add drummer region button allows you to add another region after this one. So I'm going to go back to the second
drummer
one.
Region.
And if I VO shift H on it, that's the voiceover key command to hear help tags.
Region starts at 5 parts, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick, and ends at 9 parts, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick. Drummer region. A realistic drum performance that you can edit in the drummer editor. Control click and convert to a MIDI region to edit in the piano roll editor.
So you see that region starts at measure 5 and ends at measure 9. You know, I should slow down voiceover here.
Volume 30%. Pitch 50%.
If only I remembered that when I started recording.
Rate 100%. Rate 100%. 90%, 80%, 75%, 65%.
All right, hopefully
close,
that's
drummer,
slow
region.
Enough. So if I do VO shift H again.
Region starts at 5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick, and ends at 9 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick. Drummer.
So you hear it says region starts at measure 5, ends at measure 9. Now, if you interact with this drummer region.
In drummer region, 4-eyed loop, handle.
You can adjust how long this region loops for.
Move left border, handle.
You can adjust this start point.
Move right border, handle.
And you can adjust the end point. In this case, I want to adjust the end point. So I'm going to interact with this.
In move right border, handle.
And now you know this region is 4 bars long, right? So I'm going to do VO right arrow.
4 bars, 2 beats. 5 bars. 5 bars, 2. 6 bars. 6 bars, 2 beats. 7 bars.
And if I want to move in smaller increments, I do VO shift right arrow.
7 bars, 1 beat. 2 beats. 3 beats. 8 bars.
All right, 8 bars.
Out of move right border, handle.
Interacting.
Out of drummer, region.
All right, so now if I do VO shift H.
Region starts at 5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick, and ends at 13 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick. Drummer region, a realistic.
See, that region starts at measure 5 and ends at measure 13. And so now if I play, remember I left the playhead at measure 4. So,
4 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
We got this region selected. If I do control home,
5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
Right to the start of measure 5. So now I want to look at the drummer editor. So I'm going to stop interacting with this tracks area.
Out of track, out of tracks, out of tracks,
altogether.
Out of tracks.
If I go to the right,
auto play drummer, group.
Because I have a drummer track selected, the drummer editor is what's going to show up here. So if I interact with this,
in auto play drummer editor, scroll area, in drummer, auto select button. When selected, the drummer editor always shows the current settings for the drummer region at the playhead position button. Presets pop up menu, save and delete user presets button. Presets, table, row 4 of 8. Half pipe, selected.
This is a table where you can pick a different preset. So you can interact with this table, use VO up and down arrow to select different presets, and you can hit space to hear your selection once you select it.
X slash Y pad, layout area.
The X Y pad is a really cool feature where you move the X Y pad to the left for a simpler pattern, to the right for a more complex pattern, up for a more louder pattern, more velocity, and down for a softer pattern, less velocity. So if I interact with this
in X slash Y pad, layout area, X slash Y pad, layout item.
So if I press Command U, it will set your left and right locator to whatever region is selected and turn on cycle for me. So I'm going to hit Command U. So now this region will play back on a loop.
5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
Right. So you see that's playing back on a loop. So now I can have this playback while I adjust the XY pad. So I want this to be a simpler pattern and I want it to be a little bit quieter since this is just like I'm strumming a chord and holding it for a beat here. I'm going to interact with the XY pad hit VoiceOver Command Accent to put it in a mode where I can move the XY pad. Left is simple, right is complex, up is louder, down is softer. All right, so I'm going to play, interact, activate the XY pad, and start tweaking it. So there we go.
X slash Y pad, layout item. 5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick. Start moving layout item, simple complex, 98 soft loud, 194. Left. Simple comp left. 20 points left. Position at simple complex, 58 soft loud, 194.
I'm going to take this down.
Down. 20 points down, down. 20 points down. Position at simple complex, 58 soft loud, 100, down. 20 points down, down. 20 points down. Position at simple complex, 58, down. 20 points down. Position at simple complex, 58 soft loud, 9, down. 20 points down. Position at simple complex, 58 soft, down. 20 points down. Position at simple complex, 58 soft loud, 54. Down. 20 points down, down. 20 points down. Position at simple complex, 58 soft, up. 20 points up. Position at simple complex, 58 soft loud, 34.
So you see what happens there. I take it down, and it goes from playing the snare to playing the rim shot instead because it's supposed to be really quiet. I can go left some more to make it a little simpler.
Left. 20 points left. Position at simple complex, 38 soft loud, 34.
All right. So gonna stop interacting here.
Up a bit.
Oops.
2 points up. Position at simple complex, 38 soft loud, 36.
I just need to hit escape to stop playing with the XY pad.
Stop moving the layout item.
All right.
5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
So now I can hit space to stop playback. All right. So that's one way you can adjust the drummer. I'm going to continue here.
X slash Y pad. Layout out of X slash Y pad. Layout area.
All right. So next, from the XY pad.
Drum instrument and variations. Group.
Drum instruments and variations. This is where you can select what kit pieces are being played, pick some variations for them.
Fills and swing. Group.
And fills and swings is where you can adjust the fill, how elaborate it is, how long or short it is, etc., etc. So let's go look at drum instrument and variations.
Drum instrument and variations. In drum instrument, percussion sounds. Group.
So you can choose percussion sounds to add in.
In percussion, tambourine. Unchecked. Checkbox. Shaker. Unchecked. Checkbox. Hand clap. Unchecked. Checkbox.
So you can select one of these to add it in to your drums track.
Out of percussion. 1 out of 3 percussion variations. Percussion. Dimmed. Slider.
So if you select a percussion, you can adjust variations, and I'll show you what this does in a second with the next section.
Cymbal slash tom slash hi-hat group.
So you can select cymbals, toms, or hi-hats. It's on hi-hats by default.
In cymbals, unchecked, checkbox.
You can change that to cymbals instead.
Toms, unchecked, checkbox.
You can check that if you want to bring toms in a pattern with toms.
Hi-hat, checked, checkbox.
And hi-hat is what's on by default.
Out of cymbals, 2 out of 4 hi-hat variations.
Now,
hi-hat, slider.
This changes the variation to the hi-hat.
In slider.
So, this is what it is now currently.
5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick. 5 bars, 1 beat.
If I take this to 1 out of 4.
1 out of 4 hi-hat.
This is pattern 1.
5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick. 5 bars, 1 beat, 1, 2 out of 4 hi-hat. 3 out of 4 hi-hat.
This is pattern 3 out of 4.
5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick. 5 bars, 1 beat, 1, 4 out of 4 hi-hat.
This is pattern 4 out of 4.
5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division.
So I take this back to
3 out of 2 out of 4 hi-hat variations. Out of slider. Kick and snare. Group.
And now kick and snare.
Kick. Check. Checkbox.
You can uncheck one of these
snare,
to take
check,
it out.
Checkbox.
So if I uncheck this.
Uncheck snare. Checkbox. 5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick. Five bars, one beat, one division. Out of kick and snare. Group. Follow button.
You can follow another track in a project.
5 out of 8 kick and snare variations.
Or you can do variations to interact
in
with
slider,
this.
6 out of 8 kick and snare variations.
They'll do a different kick pattern because the snare is turned off.
5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1.
All right. So there you go. And then if I want.
Out of slider.
Follow,
button.
Follow.
Press follow button. Logic Pro 10 busy. Now in untitled one. Track clean guitar. Pop up button.
And you see set to follow the clean guitar. VO space.
Menu 6 items. Distorted G-Uter.
You can select a different track in a
check mark. Clean guitar. Closing menu.
I'm gonna leave this on clean guitar for now. So if I hit space to play.
5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick. Five
And there you have it. See, it's now following that guitar part. So it's just doing the kicks on the one because there's only something on the one. And that's how fun and simple and easy Drummer can be to use. So now I want to do the same thing for the next section. And I'm going to do Command 1 to open another copy of the main window.
Now in Untitled 1, Tracks, Window, Tracks,
and
Tracks Contents, Group.
Going to interact with Track Contents.
Track 1, SoCal, Track Background.
Interact with this.
In Track 1, Add Drummer Region, Button.
And VO Space on Add.
Press Add Drummer Region, Button. Region. SoCal, Region.
Now, you can assign a key command to this, so you don't have to come into Track Contents to add a drummer region.
Add Drummer Region, Button. SoCal, Region. Region starts at 13 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick and ends at 21 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick. Drummer Region, or Add Drummer Region, Button.
Press Add Drummer Region, Button. Here.
SoCal, Region. SoCal, Region. Region starts at 21 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick and ends at 29 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick. SoCal, Region.
All right. So, for this, I am going to do VO Space SoCal, to select region. This one. And let's see what we got here. Do control home to move this to measure 13.
13 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick. 5 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick. 5 bars 1 beat 1 division 1. Cycle mode off.
Turn cycle mode off. So, control home to move to start a selected region.
13 bars 1 beat 1.
And hit play.
13 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick. Toggle channel strip solo on. 13 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick.
So you see this pattern is similar to the pattern that was being played before, but we want to turn the snare back on and make this a little bit louder. So now that we got this set up,
13 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick.
Unsolo this.
Toggle channel strip solo on. 13 bar.
I'm going to jump back into the drummer editor with command accent. So cycle between my open windows and Logic.
Now in Untitled 1, Mixer, Tracks, Window, Audio Plugin, Button.
That's the mixer we opened earlier to adjust the plugins.
Now in Untitled 1, Tracks, Window, Clean Guitar, Pop-Up Button.
And now we're back in the drummer editor.
Clean Guitar, Pop-Up Button.
And you see this region still says Clean Guitar. I'm going to change it to Distorted Guitar.
Menu 6, Distorted G-Uter.
So
closing menu.
Now,
Distorted G-Uter.
The selected region is going to follow Distorted Guitar. And
follow button. Kick and snare. Groove. In kick snare. Unchecked. Checkbox. Check snare. Checkbox.
Turn the snare back on.
Toggle channel strip solo on.
You see that's still a little quiet. So I'm jump back into the XY pad.
Out of drum instrument. X slash Y pad. Layout. In X slash Y pad. Layout area. X slash Y pad. Layout item.
And adjust this. So I'm going to hit Command U to set locators to the selected region and cycle. And now if I do VoiceOver Command and Accent, I can adjust the XY pad while this is playing back.
13 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick.
Let me unsolo this.
Toggle channel strip solo. 13 bars 1 beat 1 division 13 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick. Start moving layout item central complex 38 supply. Busy. Logic Pro 10 busy. Logic Pro busy. 100 points up. Position at simple complex 38 soft mod 136. Stop moving the layout.
All right, so I'm going to jump back to that window.
Now in Untitled 1, Mixer, Tracks, Window, Audio Plugin, Button.
I'm just going to close the mixer.
Tracks Contents,
here.
Groove, Untitled 1, Tracks, Window, Tracks Contents, Groove, Out of Tracks,
get out
Groove,
of track contents,
Tracks, Toolbar,
track
In Tracks,
header.
Edit, Menu Button, Functions, Menu Button, Out of Tracks, Groove, Tracks, Groove, In Tracks, Groove, In Tracks, Header, Groove, In Tracks, Header, Groove. 7 items, Track 1, SoCal, Groove, In Track 1, 0 pan, SERP, minus 10.0 decibels, Volume, Slider.
You turn this drummer track
in slider,
back up.
Minus, minus 3.0 des, minus, minus 1, plus 0, out of slider, out of track 1, SoCal, group, 13 bars 1, beat 1, division 1, tick.
So,
13 bars 1, beat 1, division 1, tick.
Let me turn cycle off with C.
Cycle mode off.
Going to go back to just before this.
12 bars, 11 bars, 1 beat 1
and
division 1
tick. And you'll see that this part still does the
10 bars 1, 9 bars 1 beat 1 division 1 tick.
The quiet thing. Just the kick and the hi-hats.
Thank you.
And now you see that last part is still set to just the kicks and hi-hats. So I'm going to go select that. So I'm on the drummer track.
Track one, SoCal, group.
So I'm going to use the right arrow a few times. Press control home.
1 bar, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick. 21 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick. 21
that's
bars.
The part that's just kicking
toggle
hi-hats.
Channel strip solo on. 21 right. Bars, 1 beat, 1 division, toggle
channel. Unsolo that. So now, do command accent to jump back into the drummer editor.
Now in, untitled 1, tracks, window, library, group.
And
autoplay drummer, group.
See, we lost focus.
In autoplay drummer, drummer editor, scroll area, in drum, auto select presets, pop presets, X slash Y, drum instrument and, fills and swing, group, fills and swing, drum instrument and, in drum instrument, 1, cymbal slash 2 out of 4, kick and snare, follow, clean guitar, pop up button,
changes
menu
6
items, distorted G-Uter.
And
distorted guitar 2.
Let's have it follow distorted guitar 2 this time.
Closing menu.
So now, we need to turn the snare back
follow
on.
Follow button. Kick and snare. In kick, snare. Uncheck. Check. Check snare. Check. 21 right, bars. 1 beat. 1 division. 1 tick. Out of kick and snare.
Play
group.
A more louder pattern.
2 out of. Cymbal slash. 1 out of 3 percussion. Variate. Percussion sounds. Percussion sound. Out of. X slash Y pad. In X slash Y pad. Layout area.
All right. So, once again, command U to set the selected region to cycle. So, it moves the locator to selected regions and then set it to cycle. So, we are going to play it looped and adjust the pattern again.
21 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick. In X slash Y pad, layout item. Start moving layout item simple context 38 soft cloud 36. Simple context up. Click up. 20.5. 20.5. Cat's not on. 20.5.
And there you have it.
21 bars, 1 beat.
Turn cycle off.
Cycle mode off. 20 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
And so I just move back to measure 21.
19 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
There we go.
19
actually,
bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick. 8, 7, 15 bars, 1, 14 bars, 1 beat, 1, 13 bars, 12 bars, 1 beat,
right.
1 division, 11 bars, 10 bars, 1, 9 bars, 1
9.
Beat, 1 division.
Play from here where you go from the quiet into the distorted guitar part. And there you have it. So that's a brief overview of the drummer. So next, let's take a look at some software instrument stuff, okay? So
X slash Y pad, layout item.
We're going to do command W to close this window because we don't need this drummer editor open in a separate window anymore.
Close. Now in. Untitled 1. Tracks. Track 1 SoCal. Group.
So we're back on SoCal.
Track 2 clean guitar. Track 3 distorted G. Track 4 distorted guitar 2. Track 5 tracking vocal. Track 6 hi-fi DI. Group. Track 7 Steinway grand piano. Group.
All right. Steinway grand piano. This is our software instrument track. But I don't need a piano. But a bass would be nice. So we want to change this to a bass. So this is where we're going to use a library just to find a bass patch that's ready to go for us. So I'm going to stop interacting with this.
Inspector, group, control bar, toolbar.
You see the library's not shown up here, so I'm going to hit Y. That's the shortcut to show and hide the library.
Untitled 1, library, group.
So now the library's here.
Horizontal splitter, search sounds, search, library, browser.
You can search sounds there, or you can interact with this browser.
In library, browser, piano, column, bass.
Bass. Let's see what we can do here.
Finger style bass, column
finger
2 of 2.
Finger style bass. So let's see what this sounds like.
Fretless bass.
Not that one.
Liverpool bass.
By the way, this is the bass that's used on Happy by Pharrell.
Logic Pro 10 bass, muted bass.
So you can go through.
Pick bass.
And find a couple different basses here. All right. So, you know, I'm just going to go with this one for now. We can always change the patch after the fact. So I'm going to get out of here.
Tracks, group.
Go back to the track area.
In tracks, group, tracks, in tracks, header, group, in tracks, header, group. Seven items, track seven, pick bass, group.
All right. So now you see this track says
track
pick
seven,
bass.
Pick bass, group.
So if I just hit R, it's going to count me in for two measures, and then I can play a bass line along to this part of the song. I'm going to move to...
1 bar, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
Just hit return to go to start our project. I'm going to move to measure 5.
2 bars, 3 bars, 4 bars, 1, 5 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
All right, let's see how badly I butchered this bass line. So, hit R, it's going to count me in for two measures, and then I can start playing along.
Bars, one beat, one division, one tick.
There we go. So you probably heard me mess that up a little bit.
5 bars, one beat, one division, one tick. Five bars, one beat, one division, one tick.
First of all, I'm going to hit Q to quantize this because I was a little early, so that's why you don't hear that first note. So I'm going to press Q.
Quantize selected region cells events.
Quantize the 16th note. Still didn't do it.
Five bars, one beat, one division, one tick.
We can jump into the event list here. So I'm going to do Command 7 to open event list.
Open event list. Now in. Untitled 1.
Jump into the event list.
In table. Column 1. Row 1 empty cell.
And the event list shows you
4441 scrubber group.
Position, velocity, note values, etc., etc., etc. So.
M. Position. 4441 scrubber group. Column 3. Row 1.
See, that started just before measure 5. So if I interact with
in
this.
In 4, sec 4, 4, sec 1, segment 1, segment 3, slider.
So I'm going to set this to.
4, 4, 4, 4, segment 0,
I'm
slider.
Gonna, if I VO shift space on this twice quickly, I can type in a value. So 5 space 1 space 1 space 1. And that should set it to measure 5. So VO shift space twice quickly. 5 space 1 space 1 space 1, return.
Take 8 items selected. Status, position, 5111 scrubber group.
So now.
5 bars, 1 beat, 1 to 511221 scrubber group. 51277 scrubber group. 512174 scrubber group.
You can see the different positions here.
5111 status, CH, 1 slider, num, a music sharp sign, 2 slider, column 6.
These are notes.
A music sharp sign, 2 slider, a music sharp sign, a music sharp, 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 a music sharp sign, a music sharp, 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 G2 slider.
You can see the different notes here.
G2 slider. A music sharp sign, a music, G2 slide, G2 slide, G2 slide, D music sharp sign, 2 slider, G2 slider, G2 slider, D music sharp sign, 2 slider, D music sharp sign, D music sharp, 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 F2 slider, D music sharp, F2 slider, F2 slide, F2 slider, F2 slide, F2, E2 slider.
So let me get rid of this E.
F2 slider, column 6, row 40 slider cell.
So I just did a delete or backspace on the E.
F2 slider, F2 slide, F2 slide, F2 slide, F2 slide, F2 slide, E2 slider. E2 slider, columns, F2 slider, E2, F2 slider, E2 slider, F2 slider, column, F2 slider, F2 slide, F2 slider, F2 slide, F2, 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 F2 slide, F2 slide, E2 slider, F2 slider, F2 slide, F2 slide, F2 slide, F2, 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 E2 slider.
I'm going up and down here.
Column, E2 slider, F2 slider, E2 slider, F2 slider, column 6, E2 slider, F2 slider, E2 slider, F2 slider, E2 slider, F2 slider, F2 slider, F2 slider, F2 slider, F2 slider, E2 slider, F2 slider, E2 slider. F2 slider, column 6, F2 slider, F2 slide, F2 slide, a music sharp sign, 2 slider.
I was about to show you, I could have just selected the first E and deleted them all in one fell swoop. Whip, Control, Shift, F.
A music sharp sign, 2 slider.
So yeah, I select the first E, press Control, Shift, F, would have selected all the E's after that, hit the backspace and gotten rid of all of them.
A music sharp sign, a music sharp, a music sharp, a music sharp, a music sharp sign, 2 slider.
So I'm going to play this again now. And you can adjust the velocity. So if I go to the next column over after notes, so VO right arrow.
Vel, 95 slider.
You see the velocities here. And I'm going to go VO up
117, 120, 77, 42 slider.
So these are the different velocities.
Length info, empty cell, column 8, empty cell, 033, 171 scrubber groove.
And these are the lengths. So you can see this is where I actually hit the note since these are single notes.
Empty cell, 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 03099 scrubber groove.
You can VO shift base twice quickly on this, type in a value. So you can adjust the note length as well as a starting point in the position column. All right, so that's a brief overview of using the event list. So I am going to command W to close this.
Close. Now in. Untitled 1. Tracks.
Now.
Window. Track 7. Pick bass. Group.
Let's say I have an idea for a bass part.
Track 6. Hi-Fi DI. Group.
And I'm a guitar player. So I'm going to do this bass part on my guitar. So I'm going to turn off input monitoring.
Track 5. Tracking vocal. Group.
On.
Track 4. Distorted guitar 2. Group.
This guitar track. Is input monitoring still on?
Track 3, distorted G-Uter, group. Track 2, clean guitar, group.
All right, so now.
Track 3, distorted G-Uter, track 4, distorted guitar 2, group. Track 5, tracking vocal, group. Track 6, hi-fi DI, group.
Turn it on the bass track. So this is a bass DI track. I'm gonna record a little quick passage here for the distorted section. So. Pretend like I'm playing a bass. So let me go to measure 13.
6 bars, 1 beat, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick. 13 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
So once again, it's going to count me in for two measures, and then I can record. All right, here we go. All right, so
13 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
Recorded a little something there.
Toggle channel strip solo on. 13 bars, 1 beat, 1 division, 1 tick.
I did that to show you this. You can transpose audio in Logic, and I'm going to...
In track 6, 0 pan, circular slider. Plus 0.0, in plus.
Turn the volume up slider, on this section track 6, a little bit.
13 bars,
right, 1... So... Let's say that, you know, you record this and a singer reaches out to you and say, hey, I need this in a different key. You can transpose the audio down. Obviously, the drummer track won't be affected and the MIDI track can be transposed, no problem. But you can also transpose the audio. In this case, I'm going to fake a bass part. So I'm just going to transpose this down an octave. And this is where we go into the inspector. All right. So inspector, what I like to do, once again, open another copy of the main window with command 1.
Open main window. Now in. Untitled. Tracks header. Group. Out of tracks. Group.
Get out of tracks header.
Out of track. Inspector. Group.
Go to inspector.
Expanded. Disclosure track region. Hi-Fi DI number 01. Table. No selection.
And this is the region inspector. Interact with this.
In table. Loop. Hyphen. Hyphen. Transpose. Fine tune. Transpose. Slider.
See this transpose slider. Now, the first time I interact with this and move this, it's going to take a second because it's going to turn on flex pitch for the track and adjust it. So here we go.
In slider. Minus 10.
And now it's at minus 10.
Minus 11.
I'd use VO left arrow to go to minus 10, then VO shift left arrow to go to minus 11.
Minus 12.
VO shift left arrow to go to minus 12. So now it's an octave down. Let's see what this sounds like.
13 bars, 1 beat.
Not the best sound in bass, but it might work.
Toggle channel strip
solo
off.
Turn off solo. So there you go. You can... transpose your audio down that way. So that way, if you got an idea you want to share with the bass player, you can do that as well. And also, you can turn on flex time for the audio tracks. Obviously, it's not an issue for MIDI. But if you turn flex time on for the audio tracks, you can set it to, say, you know, monophonic for the bass track, polyphonic for the guitar tracks. You can then adjust the tempo of the project and have audio change tempo just like MIDI. All right. Hope you found this overview of composing in Logic Pro X helpful. The stuff I did with the MIDI, once you're happy with it, you can copy and paste it. You can repeat it the same way you do with audio. So that's why I didn't dive too much into the MIDI stuff. I just kind of went for a brief overview of the library and what you can do with some of the MIDI sounds as well. And yeah, so once again, you can use Command R to repeat, left and right arrows to select the regions right from the track headers, use your locators to work with entire sections of the project. And yeah, happy creating, happy songwriting, happy composing in Logic. Hope you found this useful. Hope you found this helpful.